Welcome to this short video from TICRA, where we want to show you how to get easily started with a new horn design using the built-in wizard in Champ 3D. TICRA Tools starts with a splash screen where, among other options, you can choose a wizard. At the moment, there are wizards for Grasp and Champ 3D, and we select the Champ 3D here. The wizard can set up geometries for radially corrugated horns, axially corrugated horns, and even ring-focused dual reflectors. We'll demonstrate the radially corrugated horn wizard here. First, let's specify the frequency band of interest. The wizard will automatically generate some design parameters that'll guarantee a good design based on well-established rules, but the experienced user may still want to modify these if desired. We now need to specify the radius of the throat section of the horn. A good starting point is already proposed, ensuring that TE11 can propagate. You can modify this, but if you give a higher number, you may receive a warning that higher order modes that are not normally wanted may propagate in the throat. If, on the other hand, you choose a smaller size of the input guide, you may receive a warning that TE11, which is normally your desired mode, cannot propagate. We'll change the number back to something close to the original value. The wizard can set up both smooth-walled horns and radially corrugated horns, so here we select the single-depth corrugated horn. A typical design parameter for a horn is the roll-off or the taper at a certain angle. This could correspond to the subtended angle in a reflector system, or the angle to the edge of the Earth for a global horn on a satellite. Using textbook formulas, this table gives options for the horn for varying efficiencies. The pre-selected choice is a relative phase error over the feed aperture of 0.3. If we need higher efficiency, corresponding to a relative phase error less than 0.3, 0.1 for example, the resulting feed would be much longer. Going to a higher phase error doesn't necessarily improve the size of the feed compared to 0.3, and we take this as usually being a very good compromise. The wizard has now calculated parameters for the corrugations with a given pitch size and width to pitch ratio. It has included a mode converter, which gradually changes the depth of the corrugations from half of the design wavelength at the throat to a quarter wavelength for the rest of the horn. All the parameters in this menu can be changed by the expert user if needed, but again, the default values ensure a very well-functioning design. In the final wizard menu, we specify which kind of computations to be performed. By default, we will get pattern and reflection coefficients, but it's also possible to calculate various other beam parameters, such as directivity, efficiency, cross-polar peak, and so on. A parametric mechanical tolerance analysis can also be made, as well as several other calculations. We now see a cross-section of the feed. In Champ 3D, this is called a combined device, consisting of a horn interior device and a horn aperture device. The horn device is a corrugated horn section, while the aperture device is a circular symmetric horn exterior. The interior has two ports, a throat port, where eventually waveguide components could be connected to excite the feed, and the aperture port, which contains the exterior. We can insert additional points by right-clicking, so it's possible to design the outer structure in more detail. I've tried to illustrate how a flange could be defined on the feed. If the outer structure should conform with a specific mechanical design, it's of course possible to enter specific values for the coordinates in a table. We're now ready to perform the analysis of the feed by going to the command tab, where we see three commands, one for reflection coefficients, another for field analysis, and a third for various beam parameters. To execute, we need to save our project, and I simply call it Wizard. The job is now running for about 10 seconds, and we can see the results in the Results tab. As an example, I'll inspect the pattern in the 45 degree plane at the center frequency, where it has a directivity of approximately 22 dB and a taper of about minus 12 dB at 15 degrees, just as prescribed. We can see the directivity as a function of frequency in this plot. And to see the reflection coefficient, we select the scattering parameters. The reflection coefficient is anywhere better than minus 30 dB. If this good design is still not fulfilling your requirements, it's of course possible to parameterize the design by means of variables and use one of the several optimization algorithms in TICRA tools to fine-tune your design. I hope you enjoyed this presentation and found the information about the CHAMP 3D Wizard useful, and I thank you very much for your attention.